Hi, I'm Damon Smith, Extension Field Crops Pathologist for the University of Wisconsin-Madison.
And hello, my name is Shawn Conley, the State Soybean and Small Grain Specialist at UW-Madison.
We're out here, it's early 2021, and we're thinking about planting some soybeans. However, I got some questions for my man Cool Bean here. Shawn, what are your top three recommendations for soybean planting for 2021?
Yeah, those are good questions. We've been kind of walking over those the entire winter we've had this last year. And I think the first one is get in and plant early. Again, just know what your crop insurance date is and not plant any earlier than that. So I would say for most of the state of Wisconsin, for the Midwest, that'd be that last week in April, maybe starting April 20th, but no earlier than that. And that if the ground is fit and like it is today, where it's relatively dry out there, let it roll.
All right, man. What other recommendations do you have for soybeans for guys that are thinking about maybe changing some stuff up this year?
Yeah, another thing is really looking at their seeding rate recommendations. You know, farmers have been doing a good job of driving those down, and some of the work that Damon and I have been doing here on the white mold side of things and looking at some other work sponsors of the Wisconsin Soybean Marketing Board, I think farmers should roughly buy a bag an acre. And if you're in highly productive ground, drop that down, or high white mold, you know, probability, drop that seeding rate down to 120,000, and then take that seed and put it in some of the rougher ground where you might have some clay knolls or some, you know, droughty areas, and bump that up to 160.
Yeah, we like that, those lower seeding rates, definitely on the white mold ground, especially those high pressure fields for sure. So what's your take on seed treatments for soybeans?
Yeah, I've gotten a little pushback on that one. I think if you're in planting early, you know you've got SDS. I think there's a couple good products. Damon, you could talk about those in a little bit. Those fungicides work pretty good on the SDS. Also, if you have a known history of soil insects, you know, you're in a manure situation, heavy cover crop situation, maybe some of the insecticide seed treatments would be beneficial in those instances, but I'm for sure not telling all farmers to go with 100% seed treatment on all acres. I just don't think the ROI is there for that.
Yeah, I agree. I think, you know, some of these situations where it's, you're going in, you're going early, it's wet, maybe you're dropping the seeding rates down a little bit. Those are the places I think the fungicide seed treatments, you know, really shine too. So just to finish things up, talk a little about your take on nitrogen and soybean. Should we be doing it or not?
Yeah, that's another good question. If you look at Twitter sphere and all of some of the, you know, the agronomists out there in some of the I states have been really kind of pushing this idea of putting additional nitrogen out there, especially in these high yield environments. And I think I would offer a little bit of pushback in the fact that we know we've run this huge study, and the application of nitrogen at any rate rarely, if ever, gave us an ROI. Plus, it only explained 1% of the total yield variability. So I think if you're a farmer and if you got the other 99% figured out, then maybe you play with nitrogen. But again, I think given some of the issues we're having with water quality, you know, nitrogen issues as it is, we don't need to be putting on a crop that fixes its own.
All right. Well, there you have it, folks, right from Cool Bean himself. So if you'd like to learn more about planting soybeans early, visit coolbean.info. And if you'd like to learn more about the pathology side of things, feel free to visit badgercropdoc.com.